Hello everyone, thank you again so much for joining us on our IGTV here with Food by Maria and Chiquita Banana. Today we are bringing to you a delicious cookie recipe. It's made with minimal ingredients, everything you have in your pantry, super easy, super fun, delicious. Imagine banana bread, but in the shape of a cookie. Today I have a lot to tell you, but let's start off first with what you just saw. Spotify has teamed up with Chiquita. They have a very custom barcode for us where we can access music playlists and podcasts. Head on over, use your barcode, and potentially redeem your very own premium Spotify account and Chiquita Banana Bluetooth speakers. Really excited about both of those things. Music means a lot to me. So head on over, get dancing, get cooking, and make these cookies. That we have to your disposal. We have the granola recipe, we have a banoffee pie, muffins, upside down caramelized cake, and how to perfectly fry your bananas for everyday use. It's incredible. You can access them all on Food by Maria. Which brings me on today's topic. So, what we're gonna be talking about are all the different ways we can be using bananas right now. We are seeing a lot more ripe bananas, really ripe bananas. We're seeing regular yellow bananas, and we're also seeing green bananas. And I know that ultimately we do not want to waste as people. We want to consume all the foods that we're purchasing. So I want to inspire you with a few ideas on how we can be using bananas on an everyday basis. We can start first by looking into the more green and intimidating banana. I am not entirely sure how many of us out there love green bananas. I am not a particular fan of unripe bananas all the time, but I have recently started experimenting with things like incorporating them into salads, into curries, and even making French fries out of them. It's incredibly easy, and I'll just tell you a little bit more about the French fries. So you essentially peel the banana, you cut them into fry-like pieces, and then you dredge them in like a bread crumb, or you can use a different type of coating depending on if you're gluten-free, and you fry them. Season them with your seasoning of choice. I would use something like a seasoning salt, pepper, and oregano. Oh, incredible. There are so many different ways that we can make sure that we're not wasting bananas. We've done a whole blog post on this for you, so make sure you go check it out. It's ways to eliminate banana waste from your everyday life. The blog post is linked for you in the description here, so go check it out. And then I want to chat just quickly on the very ripe banana. A lot of you are intimidated by these, but I don't think you should be because they're really delicious, filled with natural sugars, super good for digestion. They're delicious. They get so sugary and caramelized. They're incredible in our fried banana recipe, but they're really, really good to use just sort of in a sugar replacement way. You can use them in your baking. You can use them in your smoothies. Don't always think that you have to use just the yellow ones. You really can't taste them, and you're actually adding nutrients to your diet. One tip that I will have for you though, similarly, like we have shown you in the past, you can cut up bananas, freeze them on trays, and then add them to separate bags. You can do the exact same thing with a very overripe banana like this. Remove it from the skin, mash it up, and then store it in the freezer in like a container, and then you can remove it from the freezer and use it in your baking or as you wish. This is obviously an incredible way to feed your children too. You can mash it up with some maybe avocado or butternut squash and feed it to your little bubbies. It's a really fun way to ensure that we're not wasting, throwing nutrients into our diet and making things fun and creative. But yeah, back to our cookies. We're just about to grab them out of the oven.